What's up, sneaker fam? Thursday, July the 12th, 2012. First of all, happy birthday to my baby sister, Toya F. Baby. Now, what did you rock or post a picture of today on Twitter and Instagram of your favorite Jordan 7? Because it's Toya's favorite, the Jordan 7. So Thursday was dubbed as Jordan 7 Thursday. I hope you post your pictures up. And I'm back with a kitchen talk number 7. It's inspired by a comment left in the comment section by Stackaholic on YouTube. I'm going to read what he said and let's get off into this. It says, so when we buy sneakers from Flight Club or eBay that other people put up for sale to make a quick buck, are we supporting the same resellers that we complain about? I mean, if it's a grail or a rare sneaker we want, we go straight online and cop with no problem, even if the price is high in some cases, but we turn around and complain. You should address this on your next video. Okay, for me, all I can speak on is me, the rare shoes. Some of the shoes behind me say from 2001, the Snakeskin 11 Low. I've been looking for this shoe since 2001. I finally came across it a few weeks ago. Wasn't a great price. More than retail, yes. But you look at this shoe from 2001, and here it is 2012, and it was on the market, still wearable. To me, it was worth the price that I paid for it. Now, it wasn't outrageous, and I look at some shoes like, say, the Ben 5, the Ben 7, the Ben 9. Those shoes are pretty much out of my price range now. So that's when I say patience comes in. Eventually, the resellers or the sellers of those shoes will come down in price. It's just a matter of patience. But I think the difference is with these newer retros coming out that are $300 or $400, and they're even priced higher than some of the older shoes that are out there. So I would rather pay a little extra for the older shoes to add to my collection that I had been looking for than to pay for a recent release shoe and the material isn't as good and it's not as much of a collector's item as, say, this shoe would be. So to me, it's a little different. You know, now, if people are just copping the recent releases just to be cool or just to fit in, then that's a bit much to be paying $300 or $400 in my opinion. Now, I also copped the Levi Pack ones not too long ago. You know, these retail for $395, I believe, when they came out. And I got this for not much more than that on eBay. It was a little bit more. I got taxed a little bit. But it wasn't $500, $600, $700, $800. Nothing like that. Nothing outrageous like that. So to get back to the question, it is a difference, in my opinion, to go after older shoes from sellers. And it's not necessarily resellers. It's just maybe one owner of this particular shoe right here that decided he didn't want any more or had something to pay off, like in the case with this one. The seller had to have some emergency money to take care of something, and I was just lucky enough to be able to be online and be able to cop that shoe that I had been looking for a while. So I think that with the older shoes online, if it's like one shoe and it's not multiple shoes of, say, a recent release that has come out like this, you know, you see somebody on there with multiple shoes of the Obsidian, then I'm not trying to purchase those. I'm not trying to give up anywhere from $275 to $300. I'd rather look for an older shoe. So that's my take on that. Let me know what your take on that is. It's just a discussion. To me, it's your money, it's my money, and if whatever you want to spend it on, you spend it on. But I refuse, for the last time, to spend it on recent release retros that I pass on or that I miss, because I passed on several shoes that have come out this year. You know, there was a comment that I cop every shoe out. No, I don't. If I copped every shoe out, I would be out of space right now. There's many shoes that I'm looking for. Like I said, the Ben 5, 7, 9, the Myro 7, Thunder Lightning 4, the Quay 9s. There's lots of shoes out there that my size is very hard to get. You know, I was lucky enough to get the Finales, and they run small, and you know, it was a size 15, and I copped it because I knew that the shoe runs small. I have some of these shoes in a size 13, and they are a narrow shoe, but oddly, this size 15 fits perfectly. So I'm going to take my choice for the birthday girl, Toya F. Baby, straight to the foot game, and then I'm going to give you an updated tour of the basement of the J's. Let's do this. Camera right. This is what I took straight to the foot game for the birthday girl. 2008 countdown pack. Pair of sevens. And you already saw the shirt. So, here we go. I'm gonna try to make this as brief as possible. I did pick up another Soul Collector magazine, because you see this one here is beat down. Page is coming out. So, I copped another one just to have. The Shoe Bible 1 through 22. And then my brother over in the UK, Team Monkey Racing, is going to hook me up with the latest one that has all of the shoes in it. So I'm waiting on that to come in. I'll definitely show that to you. Here is some of the collectible stuff that I have. The Gatorade bottles, the cologne, the Wheaties boxes. There's the magazine I was in for Sneaker Freaker, and then there's some other stuff there. But let's get back here to the shoes. Down here are the most hated, but I rock them, the Fusions. Then we work our way back. I know most of you have already seen this, but some of the new subscribers who ask. It started the numbers with the ones. This is one of my favorite pictures. I was lucky enough to go to this game, and MJ rocking the 16 without the shroud. His last game in Detroit with the Wizards was Wednesday, December the 4th, 2002. I was able to see that game. Fives. And if you follow me on Instagram, you saw these posted up last night. The great eights, the nines, the tens, the Wings poster behind it, 11s and 12s. 12s pick up there again, 13s, 14s, and 15s, 16s, and 17s, 18s, 19s, and 20s, 20s, and 21, 22s, 23s, 2009, 10, 2011, the boot game, the collab with Cole Haan, some of the clothes and jerseys, shorts, more shoes, more shoes. That's kind of how it's set up. Makes it easy for me with these on rollers to roll them up out of the way, and then I have the retro cards up here in cases. So once again, shout out to baby sister Toya F. Baby. Happy birthday to you. The morning word: never frown, even when you're sad, because you never know when someone is falling in love with your smile. This your boy Jumpman, fading to the back from the basement of the Jays. Peace.